All right, let's see if I can give it a last spin for today. I don't even know where I finished. At least I did clear all. Oh yeah, now I remember. So we basically took care of the transitions. Basically what it was is that Seahorse runs the SSH key generator utility, and the key generator utility at some point runs Seahorse ask path to, so that you can basically add your passphrase. So, and then we took care of those transitions, and then we basically cleared up the directory. So if all is well, then we should basically be able to reproduce that. So are we in enforcing mode? Get enforce. Yeah, we were. Yep. I'll search ABCTS 1635 34 added to allow, and this is not right here. Added to allow less. There's nothing here, so that should be okay. Alright, so we're clean. Let's log in and get ourselves a new SSH key. So we're logging in. Yeah. Then we are going to open that Seahorse thingy. And then we're going to use that to actually create a new key. Oh, we should also take care of imports at some point. Secure shell key, so let's continue. I'll call this something at something. Advanced key options, we'll keep it just 2048. And just create key. Now we have this passphrase. And there we have it. So let's have a look. Sneeze. Okay, so let's see if we have those transitions sorted. Seems so. So let's just, this is the big picture right here. So we have actually a transition to SSH key generator and to the ask path, and with regard to Seahorse, we have this here. So first things first, let's deal with Seahorse. Or go again. Man, this might be fever or something. So let's see where it actually searches the user. Yeah. Alright, that's it. Sorry about this, but yeah, all of a sudden I'm getting heat feverish. That's the hot weather and the trees and the flowers and all these seeds in the air. And so first we need to take care of we're going to do this in the right order. So basically Seahorse runs key gen and key gen runs ask path. So yeah, key gen. And it's all the way below. Oh, not all the way below. So what do we has here? What do we has here? So it basically wants to traverse, this can be removed. So it wants to reinsert. And that means that it also needs to traverse certificate. There's and might actually need to read those as well. So we have a dir get attribute search. I'll leave that for now. Search and no reads. Let's just assume that it just traverses the dir. We have password, we have proc. Well, that's get attribute also. Now we have this here where it actually adds a file to SSH, and that's fine. And then we have dev random. Now we have search in user home directory, and that's basically search get attribute. But not just for user home directory, also for home root. You need to be able to traverse slash home to get to slash home, my login user. And then to SSH. So that's home root T. Right? Right. Think so right. That's right. So that should when I'll take care of that, might be overlooking some small tidbits. But that seems to be it. Alright. Save and exit. Now we actually need to take care of ask pass, which basically it's a graphical application, so it's doing all that nasty stuff. Ask pass. And here we have track miner getting the attributes of GPT secret T. So we need to deal with that as well. You know, it's mining. Miner is mining. First things first, though. And this is really all the way below. So let's take care of fonts first. We can take a lot of this stuff from Seahorse, fortunately. Fonts. Remove that. Then we have X server. It's also an obvious one. What's X server? Yeah. Same deal. That's X server. And now it's actually traversing, of course, user home because it needs to do some stuff in here. So we can basically take not this, it's unfortunate. That's unfortunate. this here. Take it one step at a time, don't rush. Oh, this is actually seahorse. This cross. So let's take care of these and these. Then we have Eber's config home D, and that's also. Way too high. Let's see what that's not it. Is it? Anyone else using internationalization? I saw it, but I just don't know. Yeah, this one here. Well, we need to also search config, and that's obviously because and data. So config is the easy one, but let's just look for data with the conf. Have to be so hard. Okay, let's just do this one first. Let me change that as well. It's actually Yelp. Where I got that from. That takes care of this one here. Data home key. And this is also taken care of. Not sure why it needs to get to data, but later that will reveal why that is. It obviously has some business there, else wouldn't be searching it. Probably, yeah, I'm not sure why it is, can't speculate about that. And then we have that system debus dvar like T. Let's just search there, because this doesn't actually, I don't think right about now that it's actually connecting to the system bus. It's probably just doing something else. So let's have a look at the options that we have. Yeah, like this one. So yeah, that takes care of this one here. Then you have these left. Now it's stream connecting to the session. Use the session bus. So that means that there's going to be some chatting, most likely. I'll just look at the chatting first, because before I build, because that wouldn't make sense now, would it? So what do we have? Yeah, ask boss. Let's have a look. Like, 200 enough. Doesn't seem to be getting service on the bus, but that's okay. But this is dual or bi-directional. This is single, and this is also dual. So yeah, we haven't actually dealt with all the functionality at this point, but we use it to actually create a DPT key and a SSH key. At least that's the functionality that I'd like to support as much as possible. Actually restore cons, just have a look at what the state of our home directory is currently. And the state is good. This is exactly what I was expecting. So we have a solid home directory. So what's next? The next phase is to I'll just also create a GPT key, and if there's nothing, just some more functionality, and if that's done, then I'm going to try this in a forcing mode with don't add it. Need to basically get this done ASAP. So we have this one here. Let's create a PTP key, GPT key. I don't care. Cell signal to self. Oh yes, I forgot one something. First things first. Damn, I forgot something. Well, actually, I can edit it. It's not exactly the right place, but. And 34, we have overlooked something. We need to basically allow track miner to get attributes of GPG. And also, once you get attributes of audio home tube, we're not going to allow that. That just blows. So track minor FS, TR minor FS. TR minor FS. Let's see what we allowed for TR minor. Minor is mining. Now, I'll just add that here. This needs to be optimized, needless to say. This is something. See if we have some new debus messages. And then just see if it works in enforcing mode and just fix some loose ends. A lot of bullshit in the logs, Maya, but well, all right, so yeah, seems to work. This is export something. I'll just export it here and export this. Looks good. Okay. So yeah, that's about all the functionality that I'm initially going to support. This remote stuff and sync remote keys, that's something I will do later. I just want to get the default basics out of the way. So let's log out. And then just clear. Get rid of new PG. an exercise. And then get rid of the stuff in temp. And then just send a force and try this in a forcing mode. Nothing to do. Alright, so let's go all the way and let's test this in a forcing mode. So we're in forcing. This stuff works. Need some entropy. That seems to work. Let's see. Things aren't always what they seem. So we have keyring daemon. We have agent executing itself. See, there's always stuff that turns up when you run it in a forcing mode. It's really shitty. That's life. So search. Makes sense. GPG executes itself and searches user temptee. What is it searching for? That's probably run user somewhere. Yeah, it's searching run user. So that sucks because I don't know what it wants to do, so we have to really just take our time and but it's really annoying that you can't get all this stuff by default. Seahorse wants to use file descriptors. I'll place that in somewhere. Boom. That's about it for now. TPG agent. Oh, actually, good thing that it fails, because I was just thinking that it's TPG, but that's not it. So that's good. So TPG. A GPT needs to be able to run GPT agents, so that's actually something that we just need to support. So we're going to have to GPT runs nothing. So I need to basically do that manually. This is basically TPG agent, exactly what we need to require that. It's already can we remove this stuff? And then basically GPG runs GPG agent. But yeah, the problem is that this stuff only shows up later. See, that's just not nice. Really, tests your patience. Really, the important part is just to not panic and just take it easy. Can't actually just force this stuff. Really just need to do it. So this actually should be enable GPT to run GPT agent in the GPT agent domain. So basically need to go all over again. and do this a couple of times until it's clean. It's hard work to get yourself and then some integrity on your desktop. That's just it. Just hard work. That's all it is. See if anything related to shutting down. Doesn't seem to be. Okay, so let's say what it is at 10 and do it all over again. Jen can search SSH home key. Should be able to do that, of course. See, it's just so weird that sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. You really need to basically just keep on testing it. Seems clean. Okay. Let's try this. Filter create authorized key, permission denied. This is actually doing. See what's doing there. This makes sense. But yeah, you better believe that there's more coming where this is, where this, that where that there's more where this is coming from. So that also already tells me that it's gonna need another round. So besides creates, it needs more, probably. Oh yeah, it needs to write. Yeah, it needs to write. And to be able to write, you probably also need to open it, of course. And maybe it also needs to be able to set attributes. I are not sure. Just getting ignored. Rename. And all that stuff. There's a lot of other stuff going on. So we have a remove name and we have a rename. A lot of stuff, in other words. So it's a little bit messy here. So remove name. Remove name. And then a rename here. And this stuff here, SSH home T file. This can be appended. Right, open. And this open, we already have that. Now we can remove this here. name and link. Why should I bother? Okay, couldn't change key, then okay, that's fine. And now? Loud. This is loud. So now we're at least we had that. See what we have now. A lot of testing. Yeah, we have ask pass, searching, TTK home. And we have key gen, actually reading. Oh, that's not SSH aspart. Actually, let's just boom, go there. So, GTK, home T. Probably just searching. Okay. What else do we have? So this is taken care of. Oh yeah, we have key gen actually reading. Read. And we'll probably also need to look at some debus related stuff. It seems to be some communication problem. There seems to be some communication problem there. Because I'm pretty sure that I typed the ABC123 password. Yet, that doesn't seem. There doesn't seem to be a communication issue. So, what the hell is going on? Change the passphrase. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. This is allowed, this is allowed, this is allowed, and this is allowed. So we're done there. What else? So let's close this. Let's do a GPG key. John Smith JS at test TL. And the command is test, advanced options, is created. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. The most secure password on earth. Still generating. I need to generate some entropy. Really bad. So yeah, in the last couple of days or weeks, I've been doing all kinds of stuff that I normally don't do every day, like for example BitTorrenting and file rolling and analyzing my disk and all kinds of stuff. Now I'm generating all kinds of keys. Seems we're fine here. Let's just check out some of the properties. You can add a photo, but I don't have no photos. some file descriptor use. Add that in there somewhere. Although that's probably just not important. We might actually be able to just don't audit that actually. Well, I don't have to sign this, alright, because I already signed it. Add a subkey. Getting that shit again. It's generating. Seems stuck, but it's not stuck. So yeah. What do we have? Seems all fine. Yeah. Okay, so what else do we have for options? We can export and we can revoke actually. So let us revoke something or expire. Revoke. No reason. Export. Yeah, it seems we're pretty much done. At least for the basic functionality. Oh, we have some debussing. We have some debussing. So let's just take care of that. It's basically keyring daemon deconf. So let's just go to keyring daemon and allow keyring daemon to set deconf. So that's the conf. So yeah, that's I guess pretty much it. There's other functionality of course, but filter test. there's other functionality, of course, but like this find remote keys, that's just gonna crap out. See if the preferences work. There's not much preferences here. But find remote keys, where to search, test, and the search is gonna fail. See, could not communicate, can't resolve, blah blah blah. So this is just gonna fail. This is just going to fail. And you can see that from the HTML. It's probably connecting to HTTP or HAKP port here. So yeah, it can't resolve. It can't get the routing table, and then it's actually trying to create an UDP socket. So yeah, that's some network stuff that I would need to take care of. I can do it, by the way. Let's just do it anyways. Fuck it. Alright, so I can borrow some stuff from other modules. So let's, for example, what else do we, that print, for example, common for printing, common. See, common to print, and you have some stuff that's also actually, I can always see that it's not actually. What else? Oh yeah, shit. Of course, our transmission TTK. Oops. Transmission TTK does network connect stuff. Here we have it. So it's netconf t. No binds and shit, but we'll verify. We'll only take what we know we need. So that's basically actually Seahorse doing this stuff. I'll just add it here. And then remove the stuff that's not applicable. So netconfig, probably procnet t at some point too, maybe. And then node bind, that's pretty obvious. And this not, but this is. So this basically is connecting, and that's basically remote keys. I call it that, remote keys. Not sure if that's, and that's actually the wrong place as well. Jesus Christ. Okay, try this again. Still fails. Of course, can't connect to a port yet. It's creating a TCP socket. this thing, seahorse. So let's hopefully the same applies. See if there's some deepest chatting related to this. Doesn't seem to be any. Okay, let's try that again. LDAP port and PGP key server port, and it has a shutdown on the TCP socket. So this shutdown on the TCP socket. And then it's connecting to some ports. And of course you'll need to do some stuff. Okay, so first we need to require shutdown on TCP sockets. Require class TCP socket shutdown. And then we need to require some types, LDAP port and PGP key server. So let's try this again. Doesn't work. Create is allowed. Let's see. We are looking something. Don't seem to be. So why doesn't it? Let's just search for Bob Evans. Whoever that is. Is this functionality just not working, or am I doing something wrong, or? Don't know. Doesn't seem to be working. Doesn't seem to be working. The import doesn't work for some reason. Bob Evans. Telcom. I don't know, man, but anyways, whatever. Whatever, that functionality, I'm not sure about that. It seems to work for most parts, but yeah, there's probably some stuff that I just... There's no new ABC denial, so it's probably fine. Let's shut this down. Let's have a look at file browser. Actually know how to open that. stuff that was expected. Yeah, still nothing new. So I guess this is about it, boys. This probably just concludes. Let's have a look at show hidden files. But yeah, it can't access GPT. So there's a lot of stuff that it can't access here. GPT can't access. SSH can't access. It shouldn't be able to access it anyways. Bash profile can't access. Local. A lot of locks everywhere. Except for the generic stuff, and actually config is also reasonably, although a lot of stuff here can't also be accessed. So yeah, this is basically concludes it. I'll just throw away some stuff like these. These are created with generic types, so they can basically just can be created. Open with text editor, yeah, right, but that doesn't work because it can't open the text editor. Move to, copy to, a lot of stuff, send to. We need to do send to. Not now, but we actually need to do that. Move to trash, that should work. And then empty trash, this should work. So first things first, we took care of, we now have file roller, we have disk usage analyzer, we have files, we have image viewer, we have password and key rings. Then we have system monitor. We have the terminal. We have transmission. So basically, yeah. Next episode, we probably need to focus on Nautilus send to Nautilus connect server. We want to do that backup utility. So those are three of the high priorities, and then you have plenty low priorities, like for example you want to do the chatting, the telepathy and empathy suite, which is also a huge thing to confine, but nice, also nice because it's nice functionality. And of course you want your Firefox, your mail user agent and your IRC client, and you want Totem, and you want your rhythm box for your music. So yeah, plenty stuff to be done. And then of course maybe you'll also want your network settings and stuff like that, who knows. But anyways, for now I'm gonna log out. This is it for today. We had another. Oh yeah, now it's probably not going to work. Oh shit. This is the sixth time that we booted. So. And it's basically init 3 and then init 5 and then we're back if all goes well. Yeah, and now basically I need to do some stuff. First things first, SE module B. Then basically clear the directories and shit. that's it for today. Going to have some dinner, and then the rest of the evening I'm going to just relax. Let's kill all, see if I can find it. Oh, and of course upload these videos. Do that in the meanwhile. It's actually 3 videos today, but reasonably short videos. Killer, where are you? Claire, where are you? Come on. RM, RF, not this one. Gnu, PD, and it's all Z, home, my login. Login, 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 user, glue clean, LS all Z, temp. RM, RF, damp. Alright, so we're enforcing, remove the S module, the hiddens. We're clean. So yeah, that's it. That's really it.